非常的放松。
Now when you wake up，
当你醒来的时候
，you go into this frequency， more or less around 10 hertz。
你差不多会进入到这样子十赫兹左右的那个赫兹的频率。
And it grows another 20 hertz， and you are ready to go to work。
当它上升到二十赫兹的时候，你就准备好要上班了。
Now when you are fully active，
当你非常精力充满的时候
，you will have 40 hertz。
你就是四十赫兹的频率。
Is hertz? Hertz is the value that we use to measure the amplitude of a wave.
什么是赫兹 ？Hertz 就是一个
我们在评估一个波动。
It's just a way how we measure, like meters, like kilograms.
它是一个测量单位，就像我们那个尺啊、公里这样子。
Then we use the hertz to describe the amplitude of a wave.
所以我们用赫兹来形容那个波段的那个的它的状况。
Now every object that works with electricity in your home，
所有的物体，包括那些的电器设备，在你的家庭里
，is 50 hertz or 60 hertz，
是50或者是60赫兹。
Yes， so imagine all these vibrations that are always present in your home。
想象这所有的那个频率。总是会在你家里面存在。
And of course, you live in that environment if you have light with 60 hertz frequencies.
当然啦，你是生活在这个世上的，你在家里面那个灯的话就是60赫兹。
TVs, monitors, whatever is on is going to 60 hertz.
电视或者是那个荧幕，只要它是有电源的，它就是60赫兹左右。
So did you ever notice?How much you feel better when you go to Ulai?
所以当你到乌来的时候，你会觉得说你感受好很多。
You go in the green, far from everything.
你走向了绿色森林，然后你就远远的离开很多东西。
Did you notice the difference?
你有感知到那个不同吗
？Yes.
Yes.
Sir, did you notice the difference?
你知道这个不同哈
？I'm asking to you.Because I noticed the difference.
我正在问你，因为我知道这是不同的，但是我在问你，是吗
？See, I came back from China.
事实上，我刚从上个月从大陆回来。
Because the weather there is really polluted.
因为那边的空气事实上是非常污染的。
They really live in the hell.
他们真的是像活在地狱里面。
When you land, you realize that you landed because you feel the touchdown.
当你降落的时候，事实上你真的感觉到你降落，因为你进入了那个地方。
就是你的那个飞机就是着陆。
And then you realize, oh, we don't. But actually, you don't see nothing outside.
然后你才发现，因为飞机着陆了，它那个碰到地上，你才说，哦，原来我们到了，可是我外面什么都没看到啊，
什么都看不到。
For them, it's normal.
对他们来说，这是很正常的。
And when you breathe, you feel all your nose burning, your throat burning.
当你在呼吸的时候，就觉得你鼻子在燃烧，你的喉咙也会被灼伤的感觉。
So I came back, I didn't feel so.
所以当我回来的时候，事实上我并没有觉得很好。
And 2 days ago.
两天之前。
I really felt here burning.
我真的觉得我的肺在燃烧。
So you know what I did?
你知道我做了什么事吗
？I dropped everything, all the work I was doing.
我就把所有的一切都放下来了。
Yeah, I took the bus, I went to Ulai.
我就搭了那个公车到了乌来。
And I went deep into the forest.
真的很走非常的一直走入那个深山里面。
I walked 3 hours into the forest.
我走了像是在里面走了3个小时。
Then finally I found a fall.
我看到一个瀑布。
I take everything out and I went in.
我脱掉所有的东西，然后这样子就是去游泳。
All the fire, all the discomfort disappear.
所有那当我这样子跳下水之后，然后所有那些火啊，或是那种灼热的感觉都不见了。
Then why is how it happens? Of course I know. I'm asking to you. Why when you go in the nature, you feel immediately?
我们都问他说为什么当我们进入到大自然里面的时候我们就觉得感受很好，我知道原因，但是我在问你，你知道吗？
更多心
大自然的震动the nature's vibration。
This is the sound of the earth. This is the vibrations of the earth.
这是地球的声音，这是地球的震动。
I will let you see at the end.
我让你最后再来看。
And it's more surprising.
那你会觉得有更多的惊奇。
So most of our time we live in this environment that is against all theharmony of our body, of our planets, because the frequencies are too high.
所以我们一直活在一个对我们的健康一直很不和谐的环境里面，因为它的频率都太高了。
Then we go back home.
那我们回到家。
What do you do at home?
你回到家，你做什么事？
看电
视。
Watch TV.
Turn on the light.
Your TV.Do you have a new TV or old TV?
你有新的电视还是旧的电视？
You have a new TV, flat TV, Samsung,
你是？ 你们是
新的三星平板电视吗？还是哪一个牌子的？
Do you have HD TV?
你有高画质电视吗？ HD 高画质？
Yeah, most of you, yes.
大多数人肯定是的。
HD TV, 100Hz.
HD
高画质电视，100Hz。Yes. Then what do you do after TV?
但你对电视，
然后看完电视之后你干嘛呢？
睡觉。
Yes. Can you sleep well? Of course.
你可以看得很好吗？不行。
Now you imagine you stay all day long in 60Hz at least.
你想象一下，你一整天下来都停留在一个环境里面，最少是60Hz的环境。
Then you arrive at home, you sit in front of your TV 100Hz, even higher.
所以你回到家，你要休息的时候，你看电视，你甚至你所经验的环境是超100Hz更高的频率。
Then you off the TV.
你把电视关掉。
You don't see it, but your body, your 15 trillion cells is going like this.
你看不到，但是你身体里面的1500亿的细胞是这样子一直在。
Then you take a shower.
然后你洗个澡。
That's very good.
这洗澡非常好哦。
Because with the water, you immediately go down.
因为淋浴的过程当中，洗澡过程当中有水，然后你就会。OK, 那时候差不多就是50Hz了。
Then you go into the bed.
然后你去睡觉。
And what you have near by the bed?
你的枕头旁边放了什么东西呀？告诉我。
闹钟。
Alarm clock. Cell phone.
Your mobile phones.
你的手机。
The last GSM generations.
有一本记录报道。去年的。
They were 1800Hz.
有1800Hz，
就是最新型的手机。最新型的手机。
最新型的手机是1800Hz。
Yes. And you leave it on nearby you.
但是你是把它打开的，就是非常靠近你。
Most of the time you leave the wireless on in your room.
大部分的时间你的手机都是打开的放在房间里。
And your wireless is 862Hz. A lot.
就是你的那个无线的系统，通常你会让它开着在你旁边，它的无线系统是862Hz。
And you always read them. If you want to know about the frequencies of all the devices you use, it's written.
其实呢，如果你愿意的话，你可以去查得到，就是所有家中所用的所有的这些电器用品，它们分别是多少频率，它们列表给你看，其实可以查得到。
Then you go in the bed.
然后你去睡觉。
And you begin to play on it.
啊、你就开始这样子翻滚，就像在炒那个煎蛋一样。因为你睡不着，所以
这边煎，反面煎。
you have all these frequencies, of course, you jump like a fish into the water.
对啊，因为就是这样的频率之下，你就像一条那个鱼，鱼放在热水里面这样跳来跳去。
And in the morning you wake up, you tired.
嗯，隔天早上你起来，你觉得很累。
You see, 1 year, 2 years, 10 years, then again you get sick.
所以你看一下，一年、两年、十年下来，
然后就会生病了。
Now, for example, if you step into my home,
举例来说啊，你来到我家。
When you enter my home,
当你进入我的房间。
Just at the entrance, there is a gong.
啊，里面有一个铜锣吗？
一个锣。
一个锣。
Every time I go in, I play.
每次我进入到房间之前，我先敲一下。
And if you come to visit me, you have to play.
如果你来拜访我的话，你也必须敲一下。
Because if I play the gong, it will have its own sound. But if you play the gong, the sound will be different.
如果是我来敲这个锣的话，它会是相同的声音。如果但是你敲的话，声音是不一样的。
Then there is almost 20 of these tones.
然后大概有20个像这样的玩具。
And when I enter, I play all of them.
当我进来的时候，我每个都会敲一下。
Immediately I play music.
所以就在那个瞬间，我就开始弹奏音乐了。
What kind of?
什么样的音乐
？You know what kind of music is good for you.
你会知道什么样音乐对你是有帮助的。
When music starts for you, it's when you think about music.
音乐是当你想到它的时候，它就开始了。
What music you want to listen?
什么样的音乐你想要听嘞
？What music fit to you? It's already in you.
什么样音乐适合你？事实上，在你内在都有答案。
Now time to listen some music. Okay.
Okay. 现在我们要听一点音乐喽，时间到了。
Not I talk too much. It's only talking, no music.
你看我讲太多了，一直讲都没有音乐。
Now of course you know during all the age in which we are present in these planets, human being create a lot of instruments.
事实上，在我们人类的社会历史演进里面，我们创造了很多的音乐。
The first instrument was a drum.
我们第一个乐器是人类创造的第一个乐器是鼓。
So the first human being realized that the rhythm was touching them.
人类第一个人类了解到说节奏是有触动到他们的。
Because the rhythm is strictly connected to the movement of your body.
因为这个节奏对是很深的连接到你的身体。
And this is why, if you want to make yourself a little bit excited, you play music with rhythm.
当你要觉得让自己兴奋一点的时候，你就会拍听一些有节奏的音乐。
But if you want to go relax, you play music with less rhythm.
当你需要放松的时候，你听的音乐节奏会比较少一些。
Then immediately after, we created the instrument with good string.
然后我们下一个所发明创造出来的音乐是一种弦乐器。
Now, in both cases, the case of the drum and the case of the strings, that was done with animal skin.
所以无论它是鼓还是那个弦乐器，都是用动物的皮做的。
Now this is something interesting.
这是非常有趣的一件事。
It shows how life never ends.
这样显示到说生命永远没有终止。
Because in the tribes, it was there was a belief that the animals with which the skin was used to make the drum was continuous living while the drum was played.
在一些部落里面，他们是相信的。当那些鼓是用动物的皮所做出来的乐器，当在敲打鼓的时候，那个动物还活生生的继续延续它的生命。
Then after they realize that if they want to go a little bit higher,
后来他们了解到，他们想要到达一个比较高的状况。
Because at the end, with music, we want to go to God.
Why
we play music is because we want to go to God.
为什么我们要弹奏音乐？那是因为我们想要去 碰触到神性。
Nada Brahma, the sound creator.
Nada Brahma, 声音的创造者。
And this is why you always are looking for some sound.
这就是为什么你永远在找寻一些声音。
Composers always say, ah, if I can get that sound.
作曲家总是想说啊，如果我找到那个声音。
There is a sound that we miss.
我们总是漏失掉了一个声音。
And it's the creative sound.
就是那个创造的声音。
And of course, only those who reach very high level they can hear that sound.
当然，就只有那些到达非常高层次的人可以听得到那个声音。
So.After the drums, the human being began to pay attention in the nature, and they discovered that bamboo was making sound.
所以在鼓之后啊，那些很多还有人类发现到说，哎，那个竹子有发出一些声音。
Especially when the wind was blowing into the bamboo can was making sound.
特别是风吹过了那个竹管之后，那个竹子有发出声音来。
So we begin to create flute.
所以我们就创造了竹笛。
And what we call the wind instrument.
我们称之为管乐器。
Now what we listen is a mix of percussions, rhythm, and then later on will come the sounds of winds.
我们现在所听到的就是一个打击乐器，然后有一些节奏。然后最后会有一些管弦乐出来，
等一下会有风的那个乐器，
风的乐器
声音出来。
I choose this piece because there is almost everything inside.
我为什么选这一首歌？因为几乎所有的东西都在里面。
You can feel the rhythm, the voice of the human being, and the playing of the wind inside.
Okay, 你可以听到那个节奏。还有人声，还有风吹的出来的音乐。
那你
听。
You want to close your eyes.
或许你想要闭上你眼睛来聆听。
Music is a circle.
你会了解到音乐就是一个圆。
It's a beginning and the end.
它是开始，它也是结束。
And in this case, it's the keyboard that designed the circle.
在这个例子里面，它是用 keyboard 来一直延续着这样的一个循环。
This is the rhythm.
就是它的节奏。
You try to listen everything and start from the circle.
你会开始去想要听到所有的东西，但是这样环绕的是个循环的节奏。
And then go into the wind sounds.
然后
the
oboe. 你要看到那个风吹的乐器。是非常简单的旋律，但是它有非常清晰的节奏。
You see, when you feel the circle, you immediately sit down, and everything gets expanded.
当你感觉到这样一个循环的时候，很多东西就可以这样放下，你会觉得你被扩，你自己也感觉到是扩张的。
Now you try to breathe.Is the sound of the wind?
好，你开始透过这样的一个那个oboe 横黑笛黑管乐器来呼吸。
the wind instruments have the faculties to touch this center of your body. There is a small chakra, a small point.
所有那个风的乐器，它事实上都可以接触到这个地方。这边有一个chakra.
It's not the heart chakra.
并不是心轮，而是这边的一个轮脉轮。
In music, we consider 27 chakras, not only the seven.
就音乐来说的话，我们有20个脉轮，不是只有七个啊。
哦，
二十七个脉轮。当那个大提琴那个弦一拉的时候，立刻就可以碰触到你的心。
All the string instruments, they have the capacity to touch your mind.
所有的弦乐器都有可以接触到人心的一个能力。一般来说的话，我不会开始是用这么简单的旋律音乐，因为我比较喜欢古典音乐。但是我发现这一首很适合我们今天谈论的主题。
When you listen to different instruments playing together,
来听一下不同的乐器它所弹奏的。
Cello and piano.
这是大提琴，还有钢琴。
You know cello is very simple instrument.
你知道 cello 它是非常就是大提琴它是非常简单的乐器。
The vibrations of the cello is the vibration of the wood.
木的那个木头，那个大提琴的频率就是木头的频率。
So wood itself is very warm, and the sound of the cello is very warm.
所以木头的频率是非常温暖的，大提琴的频率也很温暖。
And piano is at the same time a percussive instrument.
钢琴它一部分是敲，它可以算是敲击乐器。
And a string instrument.
它也是弦乐器。
So it has the rhythm and the tone to touch the heart.
所以它有那样的一个节奏可以碰触你的心。
Try to feel in your body when this music is going to touch. Imagine that the music is a finger. When this finger is touching.
想象这个音乐就像是一个手指头，你觉得这手指头会碰触到你心身体的哪个部分？
And you see, when we talk about the heart, about the lungs, about the intestines, we are talking about organs.
当我们谈论到心。讲到我们的肺，还有我们的大肠，我们谈论的是这些器官。
And these organs have geographic positions in your body.
事实上，这些器官大部分都有它各自的位置在你的身体里面。
When we talk about music, the heart is not so small.
但是，当我们谈论就音乐的角度而言，心的位置不是那样的小。
The heart almost is in these regions.
所以，整个心的范围大概就是前面这么大，就在你的胸前。
When you feel something that really touch you, music that really touch you, you feel your chest expanding.
当你觉得有一些东西真的很碰触到你的时候，这个心轮是扩张的。